excuse me.
How many?
If there is no aim and object of the line,
life is like jeet. You must have any object in this world. Similarly, you have any object of the life, object of our sadhana and bhajan. If you are not knowing all these things and not going towards that, it means you have no faith in bhakti. So, what is the aim and object of our all sadhana and bhajan?
Loving Krishna.
In very beginning or what? In supreme way.
I feel I'm going towards it.
But your feeling will not do. Our feeling, which are somewhat realized, then it will be true. It may be you are thinking that you are doing well. But the teacher, examiner will know where you are going. In Mahabhav, in Braja, so be sure. Never try to be in only one stage.
Hare Krishna, Raja. Raja, in 1989, was the last time when I was in India. Was a Kumbh Mela, Allahabad. In 9 years, I mean, don't go to Senita. I mean, no chance to go back to India in these 9 years. I still I shall have a Krishna. Because I think Krishna won't bring me in India. I was Senita. And I never, I tried.
Only Disha and so I have belief, so much a strong belief in Krishna.
Okay, Maharaj, thank you very much. This is a very nice movie. Srila Prabhupada, the best temple in Europe of Srila Prabhupada is called Bhaktivedanta Mani. Because they know me from 5 years, they know me as a good devotee. I think I'm not a good devotee, but they think I'm a good devotee.
Yes.
So they make very nice reference to that mission from Indian Embassy in London. But I'm unfortunate because the president, the old president, his name was Hindu, his name was was a singing bee. He was a very friend of Hare Krishna. They say this Brahma, Brahma only. Bhima Krishna Das is the Brahma, right?
Shastri.
Bhima Krishna.
It's for the embassy of the Krishna. But the other president is become Muslim and he is very Jewish and
for Morocco, no.
He say, he say, Mario, if you talk to me your problem only a few months before,
Prabhuji, sure. Don't bother
management.
I think you should have a very good faith on Krishna.
Yeah.
You should not go to anywhere, not here and there. You should approach to Krishna. Oh, Vrindavan Bhumi, you are so merciful. And you will see that without end, you give all everything. And you have this, and always mind and chant. This is this. Very simple.
Maharaj, my mistake 20 years ago, you know what was my mistake?
Now you should transform your mistake.
Always remember India. I've been in India 10 times, every year I used to go to India. If I remember always Krishna.
No. There is no difference between this Vrindavan and that.
No, I mean India.
No.
Vrindavan is no different. Golokadam and Vrindavan.
So you should always try not to think the idea of Vrindavan.
Vrindavan.
Other ladies?
Hello, this is the mother of his wife.
This is
the sister of his wife. His wife is well?
This
is
your disciple. Yeah.
Disappeared?
Yes, yes. And he, this boy?
No.
This one is his grandson.
He's welcome to see you.
Yes. I'm happy that I'm meeting you.
I have two boys. This is my boy, yes? Yes.
And your father? Where? Your mother? Your mother is here?
Yes.
Mama, Papa.
Where?
Where
are you?
Here. My mother is Kishori and my father is Sudhadi Swami who is in Vrindavan Temple and is
very. Anything else?
Detached? Yeah, to be detached.
Only
woman.
With love and affection,
yeah.
Not from all this. Okay. You will have to attach in India. You cannot be. Like mine. You cannot be. If you are giving up this body, then really detach. But you cannot give. Otherwise, if you are giving this body, then you will die at once. You cannot detach totally with air, sunlight, water, air. Understand? But you should not involve. No. So likewise, anything, try to detach with Krishna. This course a lot, but not so much attached that you should forget Krishna. But if necessary, you can take unfavorable and help some. Otherwise, you should not be involved. Thank you. everything. He has also house and everything. But he was detached. Like Pandavas, with Draupadi and sons, kingdom, everything was there. Horses, elephants, everything was there. Sons were there. But they were not so much. They think that all these things are of Krishna. Krishna has given opportunity to me to serve, to support. You should not think that this class is mine. This is mine. This is the master of all these things. Only Krishna is yours. And you are, Krishna also will see that you are. Servant cooks, your maid servant supports your children, your maid servant doing all these things, but you have no attachment with her. You have attachment to your wife because there is very strong relation between them. She is the master of our whole home. Even your, she is the master of your heart also. You can pay even lakhs and lakhs dollars for to save her if she is ill or in danger. But you cannot pay more than $400 for your maid servant. Why? Your boy is not doing anything. And you spend so much lot of money for him. Why? Maid servant is doing so much, but you are not paying so much as you your boy, son becomes owner of everything. It depends on the relation. You should try to make a strong relationship with Krishna. That he is my beloved. And it will be by the remaining months what Gurudev has given with very strong peace and with honor. Always realize that Krishna is my beloved. He is my friend. He is my everything. If this relation is strengthened, then everything will be fine. Otherwise, mere chanting will not come. After some time, you can give up chanting. Understand something? Right. Like Yashoda, he chastises Krishna, but weeps always for her, Krishna. Weeping. She is binding but weeping. Always always remembering Krishna. If Krishna goes to cowherd, oh, she does not take anything. Always weeping, always waiting for Krishna to come. When Krishna will come? When Krishna will come? Oh, now it's evening. He has not come yet. She will be mad for this. And Srimati Radhika and Gopis, more and more. It depends on this relation. How this relation will be more stronger and stronger. Who has three relations with Krishna, they can make it. Otherwise not. And Siksha Guru can do. Or Diksha can do. If he has relation with Krishna. Understand? Any question? Anyone?
Oui, j'ai une question, mais je préfère la formuler en français.
Now it is 5 and a half.
Mais Srila Prabhupada m'est apparu en rêve et quand j'ai chanté les premières, la première fois avec Krishna, en fait c'est parce que la nuit j'avais fait un rêve de Srila Prabhupada, je marchais à côté de lui et on montait comme ça dans un puits qui était dans les ténèbres et plus on montait plus il y avait de clarté et quand j'ai vu Srila Prabhupada de côté de profil, il m'est apparu après exactement de cette façon là quand j'ai vu des films sur lui. C'est-à-dire avec le profil très noble et très aristocratique. Et quand je lui ai dit, voyant la lumière de plus en plus venir, apparaître, je lui ai dit, c'est merveilleux, il fait de plus en plus jour. Et il ne m'a même pas regardé, mais il a fait typiquement comme Srila Prabhupada le faisait, je l'ai vu après dans les films.
What are you telling?
He has joined because he has a dream of Srila Prabhupada. Sani Maharaj, he was in a deep well, walking next to Prabhupada, walking up, up, up. And the more he was going out of the well, the more light was coming. So he told Prabhupada, it's wonderful that so much light is going, darkness is going. And Prabhupada answered just by nodding his head. So it's because he started to chant Hare Krishna after having that dream. Later on, when he saw movies of Prabhupada, he saw exactly the same person that he had seen in the dream.
Et c'était en 77. Et donc cette nuit-là, quand je me suis réveillé de ce rêve, j'ai tout de suite réveillé mon ami qui était venu me chercher, me prêcher, Keshinasana. Qui était disciple de Prabhupada et qui était mon ami depuis l'âge de 17 ans. Et je lui ai raconté rapidement mon rêve et il m'a dit, c'est vraiment ce que je suis aujourd'hui, c'est Ekadashi. Et je lui ai dit, c'est quoi? Il m'a dit, je t'expliquerai plus tard, mais pour l'instant, on va prendre notre douche et tu vas chanter Hare Krishna, on va chanter Hare Krishna côte à côte. Et donc, c'était la première fois que je chantais Hare Krishna. Je ne suis pas allé à mon travail ce jour-là. Et justement qui était mis à la porte et j'ai découvert une autre grande porte qui s'ouvrait devant moi.
Ta question.
Donc la question oui, qui me bloque et qui m'a bloqué aussi. La question que j'ai et qui m'a bloqué aussi avec les chrétiens, c'est pourquoi en grande partie j'ai quitté l'environnement des chrétiens, c'est toujours la même, c'est l'enfer, c'est à propos de l'enfer. C'est souvent très caricatural. On voit le Yamaduta là, avec ses démons, les petites cornes. Enfin, ça fait un peu imagerie d'épinal, ça fait pas très sérieux. Et j'ai du mal à y croire.
Il y a une question. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it speaks about hellish planets and description of Yamadutas. They look like monsters with horns. He has a hard time to believe in it. He says it doesn't look very serious. It's like, you know, cartoon or...
Tell him that you will believe that any Atma soul is here and you are looking, you are seeing.
Est-ce que tu crois qu'il y a une âme à l'intérieur du corps?
Ouais.
Pourtant, enfin, tu la vois pas.
Je suis à l'intérieur de mon
you
corps.
Non. Tu la vois pas. Est-ce que tu la vois?
Je ne vois pas. Non.
Not seen.
But he has to believe. Because those who has realized so, they are dead. Can he tell that he is his father?
Tu peux seulement avoir la foi, tout se réduit à la foi, parce que ceux qui sont des âmes réalisées, ils ont enseigné, il y a une âme. Maharaj dit par exemple, est-ce que tu peux dire qui est ton père?
Ouais.
Comment est-ce que tu peux être sûr que c'est bien lui ton père?
Parce qu'il me ressemble, et c'est ça.
I look like him. Il y a tellement de gens qui pourraient ressembler. À qui tu pourrais ressembler?
Good day, Deco.
Je n'y crois pas, ça pourrait être quelqu'un d'autre.
I've seen that father and mother.
Est-ce que tu as vu ton père et ta mère s'unir pour te donner naissance?
Evidence.
Est-ce qu'il y a une preuve?
Non, je m'en rappelle pas.
Si I don't remember.
At that time you were not there, so you.
Tu n'étais pas là à ce moment-là.
But your mother told that he is your father.
Mais sur la base de la parole your mother? De ta mère.
Yes.
So their realized person are like mother. They have seen all these things and realized, and they are. As so many scientists say that this is true. Earth is moving around sun. We know that sun is moving. Here you see sun is was in here in morning and then. But scientists are telling that this earth is moving, you adopt this truth. Similarly, you will have to adopt the views and ideas of realized souls. Indian rishis and maharshis realize this. Even today we can see some examples of this. So it is a really fact, you will have to admit this. Otherwise, why a boy, baby comes in very rusticated family, very beautiful and very all the parts very well, and some coming in very poor family, very ugly, blackish, teeth like this, sometimes no bone, no eyes. Why this? So there is past also. She has done wrong in past. So who controls all this? He is called Jama Maharaj. And he has so many
helpers,
messengers.
Assistants.
That they go and manage all these things. Those who are doing bad actions, he made judgment that he should be punished. So they are punished. It is so, there are so many pramans, evidence for this. Still, there is evidence. A boy told that I was about to die. I saw some very ugly persons and they took me to hell. I saw and I began to
tremble.
Not in this body, but in and I saw that somewhere punished in very hot
oil.
Some are
crushed.
There are some dogs and they are taking flesh of them.
Beheaded,
but still they are not dying. So he saw, and at once they took him to the Jam. Then Jam told, oh, I have not told you to bring this man. You should
make him return to this world, and that very person should be God. And they took me very kindly to this world, and I became alive. And that person was dead. There are so many examples for this, to believe this. So don't be disturbed.
Tu traduis pas, Jérôme Tacrit?
Traduis.
Pour lui.
Je comprends l'anglais.
Mais pour les autres.
Pour les autres qui ne comprennent pas. Traduis.
Mais...
Après, en France,
c'était l'intention des Français.
Jérôme Tacrit, traduis, il y en a plein qui ne comprennent pas français.
Jérôme Tacrit, dans la marche, j'aimerais savoir si.
Après la classe.
He's asking, do you have the soul eternal relationship between each other? Between soul, is there eternal relationships?
As we have relation with brother, coming from one mother, we are brother. But we quarrel and try to cut each other because we don't realize. We know that he's my brother. But it does not be so much relationship. And if you are good and training has been given to you, you can become that is my brother. You can give your life for that. So by constitution of Jeev, all are sons of Krishna. All are servants of Krishna. So there must be any relation. If I am Swamiji has initiated so many. Now they think that we are God brother, God sister, this relation. Some avoid this, but it is against you. There should be any relation. So all the jivas, souls, have naturally and by constitution, they have relations. That is why you see that if we are so many, if there are some tigers, tiger will go to tiger, they will not come to us, whether they are fighting or loving each other, but they will go towards. And human persons, they will meet together. They will not go to meet tigers and all others. It is called Swajatiya Bhav. Swajati means?
Same family.
Like-mindedness.
So all the servants of Krishna have some relation, like brotherhood, like so many relations, but now we are covered by Maya, so we are not realizing. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been written that you should try to love and to do pranam to all each souls, whether in tree or in animals or human shape. We should try to do because Krishna is there. All jivas are part and parcels of Krishna. Same. So all are sajati. Now we should go to class.
Yeah.
Six.
Six.
Oh.
Six.
Six.
Chibaji.
But you said don't. Last hour.
Go on, Premananda.
Hari Bol.
Guru Deva Guru Deva Guru Deva.
Polish. Prabhupada qui était très, quelquefois très humoristique pendant ses classes. Il avait très souvent des jeux de mots et un humour très profond. Donc, c'est lui qui certainement est le véritable Prasannatma. Prasannatma est aussi un nom de Krishna. C'est Krishna qui est l'âme joyeuse, Prasannatma. L'âme joyeuse, c'est Krishna. Moi, je suis même pas d'as. Donc, il faut bien mettre des choses au point. Alors, Srila Prabhupada, quand il m'a initié, quand il m'a donné ce nom, Prasannatma Das, il a dit, when one becomes self-realized, he becomes joyful. Otherwise, morose. C'est la vraie définition du vrai Prasannatma, qui n'est pas là.
The truth, Prabhupada was very full of humor. In the classes, sometimes he was expressing very deep humor. And he is actually the real Prasannatma. Prasannatma is another name for Krishna, one who is always joyful. He says, I am not even Prasannatma Das. I'm not even his Das. He is a true Prasannatma. Prabhupada said when you gave him initiation, oh, your name is Prasannatma. He is always joyful when he's self-reliant, always morose otherwise.
So there's one small story I can say. Was not there, but I heard it. It's very moves, showing that very young spirit of Srila Prabhupada. Vas-y. Vas-y.
C'est une anecdote qu'on peut raconter.
J'ai dit en anglais.
Il montre en fait l'esprit très jeune de Prabhupada. On prend la très profonde.
So once he has to go to Mayapur, Dham, from Calcutta. So he used to go by car. And the devotee provide a car, Indian car. And to go from Calcutta to Mayapur. Go. Vas-y.
Alors, Prabhupada devait se rendre à Mayapur en partant de Calcutta, donc les devons arranger une voiture indienne, bien sûr, pour aller de Calcutta à Mayapur.
So they began to drive. And after some time, they remarked that there was no horn in the car, and you know what is that to have a car without horn in India? It's something impossible.
Ils sont aperçus au bout d'un moment qu'il n'y avait pas de klaxon dans la voiture. Et vous savez ce que ça veut dire une voiture sans klaxon en Inde? C'est impensable.
You cannot drive in India if you do not have a horn, because so many different problems are coming in front of you, in form of donkey, cows, tractors, so many things.
Tu ne peux pas conduire en Inde sans klaxon, c'est impossible. Il y a tellement d'obstacles qui se présentent entre les buffles, les rickshaws, les vaches, etc., les tracteurs, et donc j'en passe, c'est les meilleurs.
So Prabhupada was in front of the car, and so he said, what to do? So he asked to a devotee to provide a stainless steel plate, and he stopped the car and he said, go get a bout de bois,
stick,
go get a stick.
Le Prabhupada a demandé à lui, qui était assis à l'avant, il dit, quoi faire? Il dit, arrêtons-nous et va chercher un plat en métal et un morceau de bois.
So he took the plate, not a big plate, and the wood, and he went like that out of the window of the car, and he began to not the place Ashtanga was used to do it. The Prabhupada himself.
Voilà, il a sorti les deux mains dans la porte pour faire le, en baissant la fenêtre. Et chaque fois qu'il avait besoin, il tapait frénétiquement sur le plat en métal avec le morceau de bois.
So each time he was singing, and it's very often in India, he used to knock and knock and knock, and he was laughing and laughing.
Chaque fois qu'il avait besoin, et Dieu sait s'il y a besoin constamment pratiquement en Inde, la klaxon, on ne pas taper en riant sur ce plat pour faire le klaxon.
So he said later, the people saying that, they say, oh, this is a new kind of American horn, we should get it also.
Plus tard, les gens, les Bengalis ont dit, oh, ça c'est la dernière mode de klaxon américain, on veut faire pareil.
And this we're doing the whole trip, Prabhupada did that. For 2-3 hours, he did that, very joyfully. Srila Prabhupada, the kid, the guy.
Prabhupada a fait ça pendant tout le trajet, régulièrement, sur plusieurs heures, et très joyeusement.
Jnanatirandhasya jnananjan kalakaya Kasturunumini sangena tasmai shri gurave namaha Vancha kalpaturvhasya kakasindurvhaivaca Patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnamebhyo namo mahavadanyaya krishna prema pradayate Gurave Gaurachandraya Radhikayai Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Vartaya Paramaktaya Namo. Just would repeat.
Répétez après moi.
Namami Swaram Sachidananda Rupam Lasat Kundalam Go Kule Prajaman.
Namami Swaram Sachidananda Rupam Lasat Kundalam Go Kule Prajaman.
You can follow in this tone, then another tone. Namami Swaram Sachidananda Rupam Lasat Kundalam Gokule Prajamanam.
Namami Swaram Sachidananda Rupam Lasat Kundalam Gokule Prajamanam.
Anjaso Dadhyo Dukha Ladhavamanam.
Yaso Dadhyo Dukha Ladhavamanam.
Paramishtamatyan Tato Dritya Gopya. It has taken from Srimad Bhagavatam. I told in morning that Krishna, being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is Ishwar of Ishwar of Ishwar, He is Sarva Karanam, means cause of all causes. All causes, causes. But still, he is testing Vatsalya Rasa. And he is running here and there, naked, with so sweet
bells.
Sometimes Krishna hears himself, from where sound is coming. And playing. And thus, he made something so that Yashoda was running and following Krishna. At last he catch hold. So we should promise that in this very life I will have to pursue Krishna. Forgetting everything. Yashoda forget everything. To eat, drink, breathe, everything. And he was only absorbed in Krishna. She ran more quickly than Krishna himself. Krishna runs so such a way that demons like Jarasandha, Kaljaman, they cannot touch Krishna. They think, oh yes, I've come nearer and about to touch. But they saw at once that quickly Krishna turned over and went miles and miles away from them. They cannot touch. Even the purified mind in lakhs years of yogi, they cannot touch by mind also. Even the lotus feet of Krishna, they are very far away. Only the devotees like Yashoda can run more than Krishna. They can love more Krishna than Krishna loves that devotee. And they can control Krishna. Otherwise, no. When Yashoda took the hands of Krishna in her hands, he took by his left hand Krishna right hand and he took a stick in his right hand. Should I
beat you?
And Krishna was going here, here, there. Mother, don't. And weeping so loudly, tears were coming. And by one hand, by left hand, Krishna was doing like
rubbing his eyes.
So kajal mixed with his eyes water. Both are coming like Ganga and Jamuna. And mixing here in prayer. Very good. The what name of Rishi?
Satyabrata
Muni. He is telling, oh, if you are smiling, oh, very beautiful. But I think it is more superior that you are weeping and doing life.
And serving.
Like this, and you look very beautiful. So I want that this, your face, red, weeping, taking so much
big breaths,
and weeping, you should come in my heart. I don't want any kinds of other benediction. Never. So, he is praying like this. Krishna was weeping bitterly. So all the gopis who were assembled there, they requested Yashoda. Oh, you should not chastise more. And you should not be with this king. Be kind to this boy. We know that in this about matured age, you have a son like this boy, very beautiful and so soft, and now you are being so cruel and beating with Cain. Just to be merciful. Yashoda told, yes, I will not beat you, but I will bind you so that you should be careful for future. I will punish you by the help of that Odokal gun,
grinding
mortar. You were stolen, I'll punish both. Because those who are culprit and those who are helping him, both are culprit. So the helper, that is grind mortar, is also culprit. So I will bind both together and punish. Why she was doing so? She was thinking that Krishna is very Krishna is not a boy. He may, if I will chastise him, I have chastised him. So just he can go to Brahmandabhar and jump in Jamuna, because he is now in anger. And he may go to any forest, give it me, but I don't want. I know that he is a boy, little boy, baby. If I will bind him, and after that he will be pacified, then I will go and give my milk, and then he will be more settled, and then he will forget everything. But now if I am making him free, then he will go anywhere in the dense forest and he will not return. And what will be at that time? Any dangerous animal can attack, or he can drown in Jamuna. So I should be careful, I should be fine. And thinking so, she told his sakhis that bring some rope, I will bind him here with that
mortar.
The sakhis were telling him that he should not bind him. He should give milk and he will be pacified. But he was promised, he promised that I should make him purified. I will unpunish him so that he may, for future he will be a good boy. Otherwise he will be very naughty boy. And it will be very hard to control him. That is why I want to punish him. Sakhis brought one rope from Yashoda house. And Yashoda took it and tried to bind Krishna here. A golden chain was there from before. Yashoda has given. And Krishna, this rich vest, was only
12 fingers
in round. And golden chain was there. She tried by that rope. That rope was about 3-4 yards. She tried. But Krishna, this vest was not completed. It became 2 fingerless. Another rope was brought up. But again, she tightened them and began to
bind
again to not 3 or 4 or 1, only 2. Again, a rope was brought and it was added, and it became so long but it was not completed, two fingerless. Thus, all the robes of the Yashoda house were brought and added, but even two fingerless. Then Yashoda ordered his sakhis that bring from your own houses. They were clapping and laughing. That Yashoda, you have become mad? Have you become mad? Brahma is not written in his
forehead
that he should be blinded. But you are trying. You are saying that from morning 2-3 hours have been passed and you have not still blinded him. You cannot bind, but we are following your orders and bringing ropes from our own houses. And they brought a lot of rope. And all were together connected. But even two fingers. One round was not completed. Even what is this? Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur or Jiva Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, they had told that anyone cannot bind Krishna. Never. Because it is endless. Though it is seen that Krishna vest is in 12 fingers all round, but whole world, even cheat world, and these lakhs and lakhs worlds can be in the vest of Krishna, in the stomach of Krishna. So endless. Though there is no east, west, south, and north, up and down of Krishna. Everything is in Krishna. So how a thing arose in this world can bind Krishna? Never it can. Krishna is endless. So anything. There is nothing to Krishna. Is fine of fine. Anur api aniyan, mahato api mahiyan. If there is nothing here, very little point, how you can bind? Can you bind?
Infinity.
Infinity, anything you cannot. If it is too big, it cannot be binded. And if very Krishna can bind any jiva soul, but anyone else cannot bind jiva souls. Even it is so
atomic.
Huh?
Atomic.
Atomic. So small. Small of a small. Krishna is in this body, there is mind's body. In that, our soul. In soul, Sakshi Vishnu Tattva. In him, Radha and Krishna. So finer, finer, finer. Anyone cannot bind him. But what happened? Krishna is weeping and thinking that if Mother Yashoda binds me, then my all play will be ruined. I cannot go to play with my
friends
who are waiting just out of door. Who? Madhumangal, Subal, Dham, Sridham, Vasudham, Vasto, Krishna, Lavanga, Arjun, Madhumangal, Subal. All are waiting. All are naked. And they want, and they are looking, and by fear they are not coming here. By the fear of Yashoda. If they are coming and helping Krishna, then Yashoda will chastise all. They are saying that Yashoda is now so brave. If he goes, he will also do the same thing with us. So all are waiting and seeing. No? So But all are waiting for him. Oh, Krishna should come. So I could not pray with them. Also some girls. Who are these girls? Very little. Shrimati Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha, all are. They are waiting. Also some cows, all cows are waiting. They are not giving milk. Even their cows are there. They are giving today last legs only.
Hind legs.
Not giving milk. Milk is not coming in their orders. Why? If Krishna will come and they will see Krishna, then with vatsalya, love and affection, this milk will come. All cows are crying, doing humba, humba, humba for Krishna. I cannot go to Brahmand Ghat to play. Once Krishna was playing with boys in Brahmand Ghat. You know where is Brahmand Ghat in Kokur? Where Nanda Baba used to take bath. So at that day, all the boys, naked boys, were there, assembled and playing here and there. But at once, that playing was stopped and all were clapping and
laughing,
singing towards Krishna, like this. Krishna could not understand why they are laughing. At once he asked Madhmangal, Madhmangal, why all are laughing, you are also laughing? Oh, there is a thing. The thing is that Nanda Baba is so fair complexion, like golden complexion. And Yashoda is so beautiful, marvelous, very golden complexion. But we see that you are black. How you came from them? It is absurd. So it seems that you are not son of Yashoda and Nanda. You are son of any another. And black persons. And so they have yielded you, taken, given birth, but they were not in a stage to support you and nourish you. So they kept in a hole of a tetul tree,
tamarind
tree. And yet you were at that time weeping bitterly. So Nandava was coming to take bath in Jamuna. And out of his mercy, he took you and gave in the lap of Yashoda. Really, you are not son. Then Krishna began to weep loudly. And he went straight to Yashoda. And he began to roll down on the earth. Yashoda wanted to pacify, but she is not hearing anything. Firstly, Yashoda took him in his lap, but he began to
slip
from the earth. And very bitterly weeping. At last, anyhow, Yashoda told that you should say the reason why you are so much weeping. Then Krishna told that all boys are telling that you are not son of Yashoda and
Nanda.
So I am weeping. I want to go to my real father and mother, where they are, because you are not my real father. Who told you? Oh, all the boys are clapping and telling. Also, Baladev is supporting in their group. Then Yashoda told that I am taking oath of my deities, my Shalagram Shila. I cannot speak lie. You are my son. Surely. Then Krishna was. So all Krishna was playing like this, so he was very fond of playing. He is thinking that if Yashoda Maya will bind me, I cannot go to play. So she should not mind. At once, Jogmaya in his body, he thought that I should serve my Prabhu at length Shakti power. At once, she came in the body of Krishna. Though the body was not
bigger. Expand.
Fatter. But yet, and the rope was going longer and longer. But yet, two angles, fingers, lace. This is what one finger is. That I will bind Krishna, I will control Krishna, I will take darshan of Krishna, I will have mercy of Krishna. And we are doing practices, bhakti practices. But very sudurlabh, rare to bind Krishna. We cannot control Krishna, we cannot see Krishna with our efforts and sadhana and bhajan. But without also this, we cannot do anything. When the mercy of Krishna will come and add with this, when Krishna will see that, oh, this person, devotee is doing so much effort for me and he is now tired, seeing his labor and all these things, he will be merciful. Then his mercy plus his practice both will do at a time. And Krishna can be seen, we can have real bhakti, otherwise no, he will be controlled, otherwise no. So here Yashoda was practicing, a sadhaki practicing to have the darshan of Krishna. But when Krishna mercy will come, to see that, oh, he is hungry. He is doing so much austerities and he is striving for me, he is so much suffering for me, like Rup Sanatan, Sankhya Purvakanam Gannatibhi Kala Vashani Kritav, Nidra Harak Ahar Vihar Vijitav,
Tatsanta Vinam
Radha Krishna Pudasmati Madhurna Anande. Like Rup Sanatan. Always weeping here and there, not taking anything, dry crumbs.
Chickpeas.
Sometimes. Sometimes never. Whole night waking. No sleep at all. Always waking. Oh Radhike very one. Oh Lalite very one. Oh Krishna very one. Be merciful. Always weeping. So when we see that we become hopeless, we cannot do like this. So Krishna will be so much merciful seeing these things. One Sanatana Goswami was taking, giving parikrama of Govardhan. He has become now old. It was so hot midday. Very hot. All whole soil were
boiling.
And Sanatana Das Goswami was doing parikrama. He could not be here. At one place, he became faint. Then Krishna and Balram both came. And Baldev beat some shit from his clothes. What?
Chadar.
And Krishna put his very soft and fragrant, sweet hand on the head of Sanatana. At once, he looked and saw that, oh, beautiful Krishna and Baldev are there. And he began to weep. Krishna told, oh, Sanatana, I cannot hear this, that in these old days, and you are doing parikrama, in very hot day, daily, I cannot. So I am giving you this little shila with my footprint and cows'
footprints
and with bansi. and take it and do parikrama only this, you will have the fruit of doing parikrama. So, if you are trying so much, you have to have observed in bhakti in such a way that you have forget when to take, eat, or when to sleep, everything you are forgetting. And you can give up anything for Krishna, and then you will be Akhil Krishna, Krishnarthe Akhil Cheshta Parayan, and Krishnarthe Akhil Bhogatya. Then we will be detached from worldly, all these things, and do anything for the benefit of Krishna. Then Krishna may come. Otherwise, not. So both things be there. Our practices, what Rupa Goswami and other Goswami has shown, and also the mercy both. Because only sadhana will not do, and only mercy will not do. Like Krishna has mercy. You have fallen down on a well, in a well. Anyone is giving rope, that you should take it and I will
pull you out.
But he is not
catch hold that rope.
Not catching this one. Thus he will not come. So this rope is Krishna mercy. And to
catch hold
is our practice. Both should be there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told like this. So both is needed. Balni, not that we are practicing and Krishna is bound to give his darshan and give to his friend. Nothing.
Donc dans ce chant, ce lila de Krishna est décrit, c'est emprunté au Srimad Bhagavatam qu'on disait ce matin. Krishna est Dieu la personne suprême, le maître de tout, Ishvara Sarvabhutanam, Sarvakarana Karanam, la cause de toutes les causes, et néanmoins il savoure dans sa position de petit enfant dépendant le parfum de Vatsalya Ras. Il court tout nu avec sa ceinture à clochette qui fait un son merveilleux qui teinte, et il est poursuivi par Yashoda qui finit par l'attraper. Yashoda avait fait le vœu, c'était fait un point, c'était juré, je vais attraper Krishna. On doit également se promettre, se faire le vœu de poursuivre Krishna en oubliant tout le reste. Yashoda a fait cela, et elle courait plus vite que Krishna, et comme on disait ce matin, on doit avoir plus d'amour pour Krishna que Krishna en a pour nous. Pourtant Krishna court vite. On dit qu'Yashoda court plus que Krishna, mais pourtant, des grands démons comme Jarasandha, Kalayavan, ils couraient après Krishna. Krishna était un peu en avant, ils arrivaient presque à le rattraper, et puis l'instant d'après, Krishna était pratiquement des kilomètres en avant. Donc c'est pas possible d'attraper Krishna comme ça. Même le mental d'un yogi qui a été purifié par la sadhana, même en essayant pendant des centaines de milliers d'années, il ne peut pas arriver à atteindre les pieds par les lotus de Krishna. Seuls des dévots comme Yashoda peuvent le faire. Donc, elle courait plus vite que lui, elle aimait plus que lui. C'est seulement comme ça qu'on peut le contrôler, sinon c'est impossible. Donc, quand Yashoda a saisi les deux mains de Krishna, sa main gauche dans sa main droite, avec sa main gauche dans la main de Krishna, elle a levé sa baguette en disant « Est-ce que je vais te punir? Est-ce que je dois te battre ?» Krishna se débattait, elle lui tournait autour en essayant de se débattre. Et lui se frottait les yeux, et le kajal autour de ses yeux, plus les larmes, ça coulait et ça se rejoignait comme le Gange et la Jamuna qui se rejoignent à Prayag sur sa poitrine. Donc Satyavrata Muni dans ce bhajan, il chante « Oh Krishna, tu es tellement beau quand tu es souriant, mais en vérité, lorsque tu pleures, tu es encore plus beau. Lorsque tu pleures et que tu pousses de profonds soupirs, c'est une vision encore plus belle. Donc je prie que dans mon cœur, j'ai seulement cette vision et pas autre chose. Je ne veux pas d'autres bénédictions. » Krishna s'est mis à pleurer amèrement et les gopis assemblés ont commencé à dire à Yashoda, tu ne devrais pas réprimander et pas battre avec ta baguette, ce bel enfant, il ne faut pas le battre, tu es cruel. Yashoda a dit, bon d'accord, je ne vais pas le battre mais je lui ai promis une bonne leçon et je vais l'attacher. Je ne vais pas le battre, d'accord, mais je dois l'attacher. Il faut absolument, maintenant que je lui ai promis, si je ne le bats pas, ça va être très difficile de contrôler, il va devenir de plus en plus terrible et espiègle. Et je vais l'attacher à qui? À son complice, le mortier. Parce que quand quelqu'un est coupable d'un crime, les complices également sont punis. Donc ce mortier qui l'a aidé à dérober le beurre, c'est son complice, donc je l'attache tous les deux. En fait, elle pensait, intérieurement, j'ai réprimandé Krishna très sévèrement et maintenant il est en colère. Si je le laisse partir maintenant, il est capable, ce vaut rien, d'aller jusqu'à Brahmanaga, de sauter dans la Jamuna et de se noyer, ou bien aller au plus profond de la forêt, où il risque de se faire attaquer par des bêtes féroces. Donc il faut absolument que je le garde ici, et si je l'attachais un moment, après il va s'apaiser, je vais donner du lait, et tout ira bien. Mais les gopis ont commencé à dire, non, il ne faut pas attacher, donne-lui seulement du lait. Tu vas pas attacher ce petit enfant, tu es cruel.